I just gave our spaceship an upgrade. And we need your help with the first flight test. There's a new controller connected to the lab computer.
We see it!
Yes, that one! Try using it to fly the ship from the lab.
Let's do this! I'll go first. Vroom, vroom!
Not like that. Let me try. This isn't working.
Webster, you check the hardware.
Aw, you two. Remember, you need the hardware and software of this computer to work together to fly the ship.
Huh? Working together?
Riding a bicycle can be so much fun! But for a smooth ride, it's important that the parts of a bicycle, such as the pedal, chain, the handle, and its wheels, work together properly. This is the same for computers. A computer needs its software and hardware to work together for it to work properly. Take video games, for example. When a user presses the buttons on the hardware console, the game software understands the button presses. In response, the software moves the in-game character on the hardware monitor. Let's look at another example. How do we send emails to our friends? We use hardware to interact with the software to complete the task. In an email software application, we enter the email address and type the message using a keyboard. Then, we use a mouse to click the send button to send the email. And we can see all of this happen on a monitor. The hardware and software in a computer work seamlessly to complete any task. Look around for other places where hardware and software work together. That's right! We need to use the correct software with the correct hardware to operate the computer. Like this! Ta-da!
Whoa!
Yippee! It's working!
I'm next!
Webster and Recursola now know that software and hardware cannot work without each other. Can you think of another example of a software program and hardware devices working together?